Hurricane Dorian made landfall on the Bahamas with wind speeds of 185 miles per hour, with gusts going up over 200 miles per hour. And we know that because of hurricane hunters who fly into the storm to collect critical data and get pictures like this one, this is what is able to keep a lot of people safe. And you can imagine this is quite scary to be in the middle of, but just another day at the office for my next guest, Lieutenant Colonel Sean Cross, who's with us. So you flew into the core of this hurricane. This video is incredible. We've seen from one of your teammates a picture that has gone viral. Tell us about, especially considering we were talking in the break, you said you've flown into a storm, so not necessarily, it could be the same storm multiple times, 165 times. Tell us about being in the middle of Dorian and how this compares.
Hey, Brian, thanks for having us on. First off, glad to be here. Dorian is a very powerful Category 4 storm. Like you mentioned, it's sort of the same for us every time we go out and fly. Every storm has its own unique personality, so you never really know what to expect. But Dorian, she's very powerful, and she's been holding this very tight eye wall in a really well-defined stadium effect for the last couple of days. So the crews that are flying in and out of Dorian daily now, the squadron's on its 13th mission right now. We started in Curacao, we pulled back to Homestead, Florida, and now everything is currently flown out of Keesler Air Force Base right here in Biloxi, Mississippi. It's a very fun job. It's very thrilling to do this. It's actually incredible to see what Mother Nature has created from the inside, and what I call the belly of the beast, to be up and close and personal with a hurricane that's this powerful. It's a good ride going in. Sometimes it's smooth, sometimes it's bumpy. You just never know.
It really is beautiful as you see it, but you must, I imagine, be thinking as you're in flying through this storm, you of course are actually safe, which a lot of people would look at what you do, they think it's very scary, but you are actually very safe. When you are in the middle of this, looking at this well-formed eye wall, knowing what that means for the conditions, what are you thinking about how that is going to impact people who are on the ground, who will be experiencing this?
Right, I do think about that all the time. This is my 19th season flying this storm mission. I've flown many storms, like I said a few minutes ago, and I've also ridden out some major storms on the ground. I can tell you, Brianna, I would fly through a hurricane any day before I ride one out on the ground, if that helps the viewers out there. I can control what I'm doing in the storm environment in an aircraft, but when you're on the ground, you experience all type of tornadic activity, things like that. The storm surge, you know, that's the number one killer for people out there on the ground. It's drowning by the water. So these storms are nothing to be taken lightly. And what I always encourage people to do is listen to your emergency management officials out there on the ground. If they're telling you to evacuate, you really need to listen. We're ground zero for Hurricane Katrina back in 2005. We experienced about a 25-foot storm surge out front off the Gulf Shore on the beaches. I live up on the Back Bay in Mississippi now, and where I'm at now, they looked at about 18 feet of water that came in and had major destruction around. So these storms are nothing to play with, and people really need to pay attention and heed the precautions.
And hopefully they are doing that. Lieutenant Colonel Sean Cross, thank you so much for being with us.
Thanks for having us on.